Infodumps. Okay, wow. That is the topic for today. I think when it comes to scripting, infodumps are way, way, way more forgiving than when you're writing prose. When you're writing a novel, it's very, very important to learn how to chop up information and mix it into your prose in a very entertaining way. But when it comes to writing a comic, you don't have to worry about it as much because it's a lot less difficult. Because you have to have, you know, pictures on your page too, so you don't ever go pure info dump on people. It can get a little annoying and frustrating if you do very large amounts of text and neglect pictures, but as long as you make sure to create like engaging like compositions and art, you're gonna be fine and it's gonna be very forgiving to you. But you know, that isn't the end all be all when it comes to getting information to your reader. There's obviously a lot more than just having nice visuals to make info dumps palatable and effective. And that is exactly what I want to talk about today, because while a lot of people may stress how to deliver information in creative ways, and they may go into like show and tell, show versus tell, which is something I've talked about and definitely will expand on later. I think when it comes to comics, it's kind of the perfect time to look at what information you're giving and whether or not that is working for you or against you. So let's talk about how you should slice up for information. When it comes to information, you have to consider things like you're making a lesson plan. You're teaching your audience. You are taking a teaching role with your reader. Everything they need to know about your comic so that they can pass the final test, that's your job. And what is the final test? It's the ending of your story. If they understand the ending of your story and are fully invested in it, they pass, and you've passed as a teacher. This is kind of what makes editing and writing your script so very important, and doing it before you start working on the actual visuals of your comic. In order to info dump properly, you need to know what is on the final test. What do they need to know? In fact, I don't even worry about what they need to know until the second draft, until I've written the ending. Look at your endings after the fact and start writing down everything that your reader needs to understand in order to pass, in order to understand. This includes character backstories, motivation, world building, villains, everything. What do they need to know to enjoy this? At this stage, you'll also kind of sift through what is cool to you but irrelevant. If your cool story lore isn't required to enjoy the story, it's not going to make the list. Doesn't mean you don't share it at some point, but if it's weighing your story down, you can cut it and it'll be fine. When you understand what is needed to tell your story's ending, most likely you're going to come up with several subjects. Your reader may need to know what a dragon is, why your sorceress is evil, why the heroine wants to fight the evil sorceress, where did the hero get that magical sword, how come that sword is able to kill the dragon when the dragon's supposedly indestructible. All of those kind of questions become broad subjects that you need to break up into pieces. They're all great subjects, but like the heart of avoiding a large info dump is how you break apart these subjects into lessons. Lessons are your scenes. Each scene has one complete lesson, and if you add too many concepts to a scene, that's where you start to have problems. This is a very, very difficult process, and you need to cut up your subjects in order to not overwhelm or bore your reader by cutting them up too finely. This is where you need to put yourselves in their shoes, and eventually you have to get people to actually read your story to see if you're doing it correctly. Basically, it comes in two different forms. You have your general impressions and your in-depth discussions. General impressions are usually through showing. You introduce a wide variety of concepts, and this kind of gives your reader a footing in the world or the footing in a particular concept. This can be like an establishing shot, like you might see a bunch of fantasy creatures mulling about. And, you know, some astute readers may gather more in-depth information that you kind of sew into that shot, but you can't reliably totally assume that all readers are gonna be on the same page when it comes to the information you're sharing. It's just a general primer that you give them. These impressions are really important because as long as you don't obscure knowledge for too long, then is like sensible and like that is sensible and reasonable. It'll generate interest. Like seeing dragons flying about your city tells your readers, there's cool dragons that fly about the city, and your reader goes, oh heck, that's really cool, I want to know more about these dragons. And that gives you more permission to go on a bit of an info dumpy spiel later, because they are invested in this cool thing they saw, and they want to know more now. And that's your first lesson. You're done. Like, general impressions are really good for really large concepts, like who is your main character? You know, you want a general impression of your main character. You want to see them being like, this is a cool person I want to know about. That is your primer. That is your general impression. Like, this is a cool world, I want to know more about it. That typically is your first lesson, unless we're talking about something that really is just basic, but it needs to be told. There's no real cool way to get it across, or it's just so small and insignificant that building so much hype around it wouldn't be worth it. Yeah, so like in that case, dragons exist and they fly about is the lesson. So in the next scene, you might go into a more in-depth lesson, the in-depth discussions that I was talking about. And this might be where you see the character interacting with a dragon and struggling for the dragon to like acknowledge it or whatever. And this is building up a core relationship. Like, if we're assuming that this character is going to be a main character, this is building up that there's relationships between humans and dragons, and they can be difficult. And this relationship in particular is one we should pay attention to. This information is a lot more specific rather than a general impression. In a following scene, the lesson may be even more direct. You might have like the character complaining about how she'll never succeed at training this dang dragon before the Firelight Festival or something. And again, this is a very focused, specific scene about this specific concept. General impressions like happen during these scenes too. Like in the one prior, you're gonna be gaining general impressions. Like in the one prior, you're gonna be learning more about the world just by seeing the interaction, but you're not going in depth with it. And with the second scene I mentioned, with her discussing like the Firelight Festival, you might briefly mention that festival, but since that this scene isn't specifically about it, we're not going to just go off the rails and start discussing the Firelight Festival because it distracts from the main point. Your general impressions and general information shouldn't become distracting. So you can add it up to the point of it just like either being too distracting or too confusing. You got to keep it in check, and you gotta like not overwhelm your reader with too much side information. As long as your core point is still like visible throughout, you'll be fine. Once you're using so much jargon that it's not intriguing anymore, it's just overwhelming, that's where you have to scale back. Maybe it's not the time to bring up all sorts of things about the Firelight Festival. Maybe it's not time to bring up other concepts like elves and mana or whatever. Like, that's just too much for the reader. So a brief offhanded remark about one thing is fine, but you're gonna cross a line at some point. Okay, I hope that makes sense. The next important thing you need to know about info dumping is that lessons, especially your most integral ones, need to be reinforced. This is like an especially hard concept to grasp, at least it was for me, but it's okay to reiterate, you know, like, especially when there's so much information in your comic always coming at people, you need to make sure that people know what is important, and repetition is one of your strongest tools in doing this. Okay, but how do you do this repeating thing without, like, repeating the same scene over and over again? Like, wouldn't that get boring? It would, okay? So, in order to repeat information, you can couple it with new information. Usually the easiest way to do this and have it happen is you have a character that is struggling with said information and you have them discuss it. I call these scenes, I was thinking about X scenes because it usually starts with a character in my first draft being like, I was thinking about this thing that we just learned and I want to talk about it and how I feel about it. And when you do this, what you're doing is you're reiterating the information you learned before. You have your character being like, I was thinking about dragon riding and like how this is a thing. And as they talk about this, they reveal maybe a little bit of character information. Maybe they go more in depth about previous information. But it's like kind of waves of the ocean where it's like one goes over the other. It's like layering, I guess. Like you put down one layer of paint and you bring it so far, and then you bring down like another layer of paint. I don't know. I can't find a really good metaphor for this. Repeating your point, repeating your information will strengthen it, and it's more forgivable if you use that repetition to springboard off into something new entirely. It's just really helpful. It's a really good tool you have in your belt. Totally recommend that you use it. Just make sure you take another spin with it when you repeat it, and you'll be fine. Like, that's a really good way to chop it in and make people remember it, you know? Like I was saying, you're building a lesson plan here, and review is a very important thing, you know? Your readers aren't going to be doing homework, so it's okay, especially if you have like a long bit of work, to go into like a review period and be like, okay, so this is all the stuff that we have learned. Here's some new ideas about this stuff that we've learned, but since you've already introduced it, it doesn't count as this scene now being about this thing we've previously introduced. As long as your reader already knows information, it no longer is a lesson, and you are allowed to spread it in liberally throughout your story, I guess. Oh man, I think I'm doing a poor job at explaining this. Let me know in the comments if you need, like, further stuff. Anyways, I think, like, in the end, the most important way to avoid info dumping is to get people to read your script. You can prevent so many problems by asking people to read your script. And when you do this, ask them to point out anything boring and anything confusing. Confusing means that your information is either going too fast, you're providing too much in a lesson, or you are not adding enough. They need more lessons. They don't understand something. You have to pinpoint what it is that they're not understanding and either break a scene up into multiple chunks so that the information is reiterated on, or is like given more focus, given more time by itself, or you need to add more scenes to flesh out something that you haven't already. And on the other side of things, if your reader starts marking things down as boring, it means that they know this information or they're not gathering anything new from this, and you need to speed up a bit. Like, it's time to speed up. They're getting things way faster than they should, and you are moving too slow for them. I mean, that's typically what it means. It can mean other things. And also have them write out questions as they pop into their heads too. I found this really helpful. Even if the stories I got help on, I never was able to turn into really good stories, it was very good to have someone write down all the questions they had as they popped into their head. Because even if I wasn't going to answer those questions, it was very good to understand how my writing leads people to think different things. And getting a sense of like how readers start to think and perceive things can really help you anticipate what you need to teach them. And it's all very intuitive, and it's definitely something that you need to learn. So again, share your scripts and get this knowledge. And like I said, a reader is going to be very, very forgiving of an info dump if the text they're getting isn't super dense and there's plenty of visuals going around with it. I might get into more tricks in the future about how to like make the information a lot more seamless and added into dialogue, but I'm gonna stop here for now because I feel like I'm loading you up with too much information, and you know, I have to edit this because I'm being bones again and I'm being late to recording. But I get them out, so, you know, that's fine. Thank you so much for watching. You know, check out links below. There's tons of things. You can, like, support us. You can hang out with us however you please. Or you can just ignore it. That's fine, too. You could also give me a like, give me a high five, and merry holidays. Merry, merry holidays. And happy Christmas if you celebrate it. Okay, goodbye.